Hey guys, Chad Trades here. In this video, I want to show you one of the most common and my favorite setups that I take almost every single day, every single morning, that makes me a consistently profitable trader. So what I want to do in this video is I want to show you exactly what I do before the market opens in pre-market and exactly what I'm looking for this setup to appear. And if I had to trade one setup for the rest of my life, it would be this setup because it's the most simple one. It happens multiple times throughout the day so we can get multiple trades out of it. And it gives me around a 70% win rate. So with that being said, super excited to show this to you guys. Let's dive straight into it. All right, so what is the setup that makes me a consistently profitable trader? Well, I actually took this setup today. As you can see, if I just go into my account, you can see this is my live trading account. It ended up making me around $5,400 in P&L today. So anyways, let's go and dive straight into this, right? So the first thing you're gonna need to do in order to actually take this setup, so I recommend to do this before the market opens during pre-market, and this is just to update your levels, right? So if I go into my chart here, as you can see, I personally trade either ES, the S&P 500, or NASDAQ. Those are pretty much the only two things I trade through futures. And what you wanna do is before the market opens, right? So none of this happened, you wanna update your levels, right? So you wanna go on the bigger timeframes, the 1 hour, the 5 minute timeframes, and see where the significant levels are, right? So if I just kinda zoom out, let's go into the 5 minute. As you can see, I have everything marked and organized before the market opens. So for example, we have this demand zone down here, and I kind of give myself a note, you know, don't take any short trades right here because this is where the market could potentially reverse. We also have this, right? This old resistance area from after hours. I know that we could potentially bounce off this level because old resistance tends to become new support, right? So I have this marked before the market opened. I also have the new highs for the stock market marked before the market opened, which we end up surpassing as well. So knowing how to mark your levels, whether it's supply and demand zones or support and resistance, is gonna be crucial for actually knowing where to take your trades. So if you guys kind of struggle with making your levels and you're kind of just unsure about it, I do have a free Discord community where I post my levels every single day for the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ market. So as you can see, I just posted inside my trading plan, post my levels for ES and NQ. So if you guys would like to see my levels every single day in here, like I said, this community is completely free and open to the public. We'd love to have you inside. If you guys do wanna join, all you have to do is click on the first link in the description below this video. So once you update your levels and you kind of know where we're trading at, the next thing you're gonna need to do in order to actually take the setup, and this is very important, right? And this is basically waiting for a trend to develop. Okay, so if I go back into the charts here, the way I determine what the trend for the day is and what I'm gonna be focusing on, whether it's going long or going short on the market, is I wanna look at the VWAP, right? The VWAP is of just the volume weighted average price. So that's like the fair value price. So if we're trading above the VWAP, that means I'm only looking to go long. Right, if we're trading below the VWAP, I'm only looking for setups to go short. And as you can see today, we've been trading above the VWAP this whole entire time. So therefore, going long is a much higher probability than trying to short the market, right? Trying to go against the trend. Sure, there's a few times where we went down, but the majority of the day we've been going up because the trend is up. So therefore, it's a higher probability if we only focus on going long. Right, same thing yesterday. We're below the VWAP most of the day. There is a higher probability that you made money, that your trades work, if you only focus on taking short trades. Now, one of the rules I have placed for myself for this setup is I'm not gonna take any trades the first 30 minutes of the market open. The reason being is because usually the first 30 minutes, we're kind of, you know, we're always up and down. We're trying to see what the trend is, right? Buyers and sellers are battling it out and we're not really sure what the trend is yet, right? So I always recommend to wait the first 30 minutes, let the market do its thing, and then start to see what that trend is. So for example, if we go into today, right, the market opened right here, and we can see the first 30 minutes, we kind of came down, and then we got bought back up, and then we started pulling back, and then 10 a.m. Eastern time was around right here. This is where I was able to actually start looking for setups that I can take. All right, so once you know the levels and where we're at, then you know the trend, right, what you're gonna be focusing on, whether it's long or short, based on if we're above or below the VWAP. The last and final thing to do, again, this setup is very simple, is literally just waiting for a pullback, right? So since we're trading with the trend, we wanna wait for the pullback to get in. And then ideally, right, since we're trading with the trend, we're gonna go and make new highs, right? So let's say we go up, we wait for the pullback, get in, and then ideally if that trend continues, right, which it has a high probability of doing since we're above the VWAP, right? We're gonna go and ride it to new heights. Now, the hard part about this is knowing how much are we going to pull back on that trend pullback. And this is why I have another rule in place. So this is like the third thing I'm looking for is I wanna get in after we get an entry confirmation, right? So basically a confirmation that, hey, we pulled back, now we're starting to go up and going to make those new highs. So there's a couple different ways you can do this as far as getting that entry confirmation, knowing when we're gonna start going back up. The first thing you need to do is knowing where the levels are, right? So we can see, again, I don't trade till 10 a.m. Eastern time. So before 10 a.m. even happened, I noticed that this level was starting to kind of hold, right? So I could have drew the zone and knowing that this is potentially where we're going to pull back, right? Because again, I'm only looking for longs since we're above this pink VWAP line. Now, once we pull back to this level where we can potentially bounce, we wanna wait for that entry confirmation. So there's two ways you can do this, right? You can either wait for a reversal candle or you can use the Heikinashi candles and wait for a nice big green candle and get in after that candle closes. So I've been testing out these Heikinashi candles. Basically, if you don't know what these are, it's not based on time, these candles. We're on a 1 minute time frame, but the candle's not based on time. What it's based on is the average of the past two candles, and it also factors in volume into how the candle is actually structured. So typically when we do get a green candle close, we're gonna keep on going up, right? It stays more green versus if I change it to a normal candlestick chart. So just watch the chart here. You can kind of see, you know, how this is all green. There's two red candles in this whole entire uptrend. If we change it to a candlestick chart, we can see the price action is less smooth, right? There's more red and green happening because again, these candles are just based on when it opened and when it closed, right? It's just based on time. It doesn't factor in any volume. It doesn't factor in the past two candles. So if you're gonna use the regular candlestick charts, what I would wait for is some kind of reversal candle with elevated volume, right? Something like this, where we had a little bit of elevated volume and a reversal looking candle towards the bottom of this level. Now, obviously if you got in right after this candle, this trade would have worked out and you could have rode this trend pullback to new highs and took your profits right when we got these new highs, right? Now, again, I've been testing using these Heikinashi candles and it's actually increased my win rate. I've only been using it the past week or so, but so far I've only had one red trade this whole time using it out of like 7 trades. So it's been working a lot more, it's more consistent, and I'm able to kind of just hold my trades longer. And using the Heikinashi candles, you're kind of just paying for an extra confirmation because instead of getting in at the reversal candle and then potentially, you know, getting stopped out right after that candle closes, that can definitely happen sometimes if you are getting in after reversal candles. If you change the Heikinashi candles, right, so we're just gonna change the Heikinashi right here, what we want to wait for, if we kind of zoom in here, is we want to wait for a big green candle structure, right? So we can see, again, I don't take any trades until 10 a.m. Eastern time. So I want to wait for a big green candle. So we can see we had a big green candle right here. We had a long wick at the top and we want to see no wick at the bottom. Okay, so if we see a candle like this where we had a big candle, big move up with no wick at the bottom, and we have elevated volume on this candle, that tells me that buyers were very strong on this candle. And chances are we're gonna start surpassing new highs, right? After we pull back, after we have all these other confirmations to actually know where we're trading. Again, we're looking at the trend, we're only looking for longs, we're waiting for a pullback to a level, right? Which we had here. Then we're waiting for that green candle structure with elevated volume to get in. So basically this is my trade today. I got in right after this candle. So I got in at around 17,753 and I'm able to put my stop right under this candle right here. So I was risking about 12 or 13 points on this trade. So that is the difference with Heikinashi candles. You don't have to put your lows, you know, at the very bottom like you would with reversal candles. You're able to put it right below the bottom of this candle since this is where all the buyers kicked in and price should hold above there. So that's one of the things I really like about these candles is not only are you paying for extra confirmation, but you're also able to still take very small risk trades because you don't have to put your stop loss way at the bottom, even though we're getting in later. we can put it right below that big candle structure, right? And that's pretty much what I did today. There's essentially no drawdown on this trade, and I was able to ride this thing all the way to new highs. And I started trimming at around 17,800, was able to make around 40 points on this trade, even though I only risked around 12 points. So anyways, guys, that's pretty much the whole thing you need to do in order to take this setup. I call it the trend pullback setup. Basically, looking for the levels, update your levels before the market opens. Don't trade the first 30 minutes. Wait for the trend to develop. Are we trading above the VWAP, below the VWAP? If we're trading above, only look for longs, right? You get the point there. And then waiting for a pullback to that level, and then waiting for either a reversal candle if you're trading regular candlestick charts, or if you want to use the Heikinashi candles, waiting for that big green candle with no wick at the bottom, getting in there, putting your stop right below there and riding it all the way to new highs. Again, this is a very common setup that will happen multiple times throughout the day, because a lot of times, you know, we'll be trending up all day, but we'll get multiple pullbacks. And on those pullbacks, you can go and get in long and ride it to new highs. And same thing on the downside, if we're going down, right? Wait for the pullback up to the level and then getting in and ride it to new lows. Like I said, this is one of my most favorite and common setups I take in the market. So anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this video. Like I said before, if you guys want to join our free Discord community where I post my levels every single day in here, I also post my trade recaps, and you'll be able to chat with all kinds of other traders as well. Again, we'd love to have you inside. All you have to do to join us is go to the first link in the description below, or just head over to this link right here. That being said, guys, hope you enjoyed this one, and I'll see you in my next video with another day trading lesson.